Welcome to my channel from under the hypnosis, and this is another video about the body consciousness or lower consciousness. And in this case it will be a rather in the face video, because it's about the downsides of emotions. And of course I don't want to say that we don't experience emotions anymore on this planet, but it should be from a clear mind, it should be from a clear consciousness, and you should not be surrendered to those kind of emotions, and certainly not the negative impacts of it. And now if I take this picture, then I explained that we are a body consciousness, those is this range region, and we are a soul consciousness, and if we even grow higher, then we go to the cosmic consciousness field. But on this planet there is an illness, and that illness is subordination to our emotions, and that keeps us in our lower consciousness. And then maybe a lot of people will say, yeah, but it is not that serious, ain't it? But if you look at those emotions, so your individual side of energy is adrenaline. And if you use a hard drug like speed, then you will see that that speed itself is doing nothing, but it is stimulating in your bone marrow the making of adrenaline, and that's why you feel so powerful. And then suddenly you will see that a lot of people on this planet are looking for this powerful energy by sports and all those kind of things. So suddenly you will see that those emotions, you can compare them with hard drugs. And if you go to our collective side, then we are constantly looking for pleasurable feelings, and those feelings are endorphins, and or endorphin is the main compound of heroin, opium, morphine. So we are talking about hard drugs again. And the other nice flavor we are always for on the look for is dopamine. And dopamine, you can compare it with MDMA, that's how it is called here. It's also a party drugs that gives you that happy collective state feeling. So in other words, now you suddenly see that you live on a planet with 7 billion junkies. And why is that? Because our birth was already a traumatic experience, and then growing up was also a traumatic experience. First the grow pains, digestion pains, your teeth came through, then with your head you experienced the whole living room around you when you began to walk, and then your first fairy tales about fear of the witch and fear of the wolf, and then you went to school, and yeah, of course there was no competition at all on middle or high emotional level about not want to be a loser, to feel stupider, uglier, weaker, lower, or nothing. And it was all about winning, being smarter, prettier, stronger, higher, and being something. And of course later on in life, work and all those things and all the restrictions you had from the law and what you had to pay and taxes was all on the high emotional level, middle and high emotional level. So from the day we were born, we were pressed into the body consciousness. And that's why a lot of people think that it is the way it is, that's how it is to be a human being. But of course I also explained in one of the other parts that there is a big problem, because here this is your balance point, the balance point of the four main emotions. And if you go up in emotions, then you will suddenly become more of a junkie. So that means your I separation consciousness, the need for compensations, becomes bigger. And that translates also in that your polarity, that is neutral, suddenly becomes colored by emotions to a negative polarity. So you only want to see the things you want to see, only know the things you want to know. And finally, even on this level, on the middle and the high level, it is not about knowledge anymore. It's only about compensation. You want to feel good. And what will you notice, of course, when you walk on the street and you ask a person, how are you? What does this person say? I'm feeling good, my man. So that means he's saying, I'm a junkie, my man. So the emotions of dopamine and endorphin are ruling his life. Because he is looking for the good feeling, and that's why he wants to feel good, and that's why he says, I feel good. So this is really a video about the downsides and what the effects are. So if you are in full consciousness reach, you can of course enjoy sometimes the emotions, because that also makes human life interesting. But not if the emotions are controlling you. And that's a little bit the problem of nowadays. That's the sickness that is going around this world. Now and then, of course, we can take a look, because let's first go to this point. Because I was stretching out all the time the middle point of everything, the silent point, the point of inner peace, the point of balance. And it's also on the electrical magnetical field, there's a point of balance. Your four emotions have a point of balance. And also from your body consciousness going to your soul consciousness, your heart chakra, your higher heart point is the balance point, is the silence point where people are looking for during meditations. And real simple, go to that silent point. If you imagine that you have to be nothing, and go to that silent inner point just for a moment. Then you will notice suddenly there is no polarity, there is no coloration, and suddenly you begin to notice, I don't have to be something to feel peaceful. And from that point, you are not addicted to your emotions anymore. From that point, you can look at your emotions without that the emotions are controlling you. And that is a really big difference. So that's why I stress, have so much attention to that point, that I stress it out so much. It's really important to be there. But of course, that's what we didn't learn in this society. It was always trying to seduce you to the middle and high emotional level. So this is really a junky planet at the moment right now. Now, and if you then take a look at what it means on the individual side, I made three pictures, one about the individual side, the collective side, what it means, how friends and relationships can look at you. I don't say it's always that time, but most of the time it is, and what the effects are on the world. So let's take a look. And of course it's confronting, but it's the way it is. And you only see it, of course, this reality, when you are at that silent point. Because and on that silent point you can see clear. And otherwise, you are the same as the people who are visiting you, emotional inferiority, looking for endorphin and dopamine, because you are a junkie, because you need balance, because otherwise it doesn't give you inner peace. So, and now let's take a look again, of course, biochemical addiction to emotions. That's what it means, emotional inferiority. And everybody thinks that's the way life is, but it ain't. Adrenaline, you can compare it to speed. Dopamine, you can compare it to MDMA. And endorphin, you can compare it to heroin, or morphine, or other opiates, because it's the same product. So if you are against drugs, well, then you are against yourself. Yeah, and because there's of the biochemical fluctuations and environmental conditions around you, you never feel balance, imbalance. And you do not experience an inner peace. Most people, if I ask them, can you experience your silent point? It's not silent. It's disturbed with all kinds of energies, emotions. That's because they are, little junkies. And because of this, we are on the look and very vulnerable for positive impulses. Addiction compensation. Busy with feeling good. And of course, because it's about body consciousness emotions, we look for it in the outside world and not in the inside world, where it is already in balance, where it is already peaceful. And that's what I of course explained, which we are looking for outside ourselves, no matter what. And then making money. And money is also, when you are emotional inferior to your common sense, then money is everything, because money is dopamine. And buying things, and of course it's really a fake reality you live, because then when you put on the gas of your V12 engine and you feel the power of it, then you think you are the same. You think that you are powerful. But that is of course a misleading thing from the emotions of dopamine and endorphin. Because if you are really in balance, then you have a really different look at those kind of people. Because then you see they are emotional junkies, far away from being a common sense being. And also those guys, they enjoy that they have more than you. So it's an I separation consciousness also. It's a consciousness about feeling better, being superior. And of course you think, I know those kind of people. But you don't recognize it also with your friendships and maybe even your relationships. But that will be the second picture. And of course, those kind of things is only short-term happiness to compensate. But because it's an addiction, every time you need more. So you will never be happy. These kind of emotions, your clear, unbiased visions are colored to a negative, polarized, based self-interest reality, to separation. That's a little bit of the problem. It should be unbiased, it should be a clear vision you have, but because of those emotions you are only looking, that is helping you with your addictions. So you're only looking for things you find positive, and emotionally you get rejected to everything else because you are a junkie, because emotions are making you at the moment and not your consciousness. And of course that creates separation. And if you see a look at the world, of course it's all separation, it's all layers of people with different thoughts and rejecting all other kind of people living in their own islands and paradises. It's all because of the programming of emotional inferiority into the common sense of people, which is a plague on this planet at the moment. What personal growth enormously restricts, because it's not about your consciousness and your insights anymore, it's about compensation of emotions getting your drugs of dopamine and endorphin. And because of that, looking only for your own truths, because that feels safe, because that is giving you the dopamine and the endorphins, and everything else can be a threat. So everything else is emotionally rejected. And because of that, you begin to experience life in a bad way. Because of those rejections, they are fearful. And through those negative polarization emotions, more pollutions comes up. Because you have not a real stable consciousness concentrated on a zero field where you don't have to be anything. So, because then you are really standing in your own power, because your consciousness is working clear. But you are on an emotionally based consciousness of superiority, and because of that you get frustrated by everything that's threatening that. It's not about the insight of information that you really thought about it. No, it's pure an emotional rejection. And then that's, of course, that you can recognize also maybe around you. And that makes that people feel constantly personally attacked. That's what you see a lot. Even the weather is against them. Oh, when I'm free, then it's always raining. So they see the world as against you. And not as really unbiased, because things are just happening. But because of the coloring of the emotions, you think it's personally. And a nice thing also is, because this world is fractal, that your bad thought, if you think that somebody is against you, and you will study that person, that it fits exactly. That person is doing all the things you thought. So you even think that you are really seeing the truth, while it ain't. Because it's a junky system of hard drugs emotions. It's polluting your sight. And of course another downside is that the world around you is determining how you feel. Because you are not on your stable zen point. So emotions are making up who you are. And then, of course, that is giving a problem. And you are not in your own power also anymore, because if you have a superior feeling over everything, because that's the only way how you can cope with the world, and suddenly you meet somebody who is knocking off that emotion of feeling superior, then you become crazy. So yeah, you really call that higher consciousness, of course. It's all because it's a junky consciousness. But a lot of people think that's normal, to feel a wonderful person. Oh, I'm so good, and I'm la la la. But what I really tell, junky emotions are controlling my mind. That's what they say. And what's, of course, a real big downside of a consciousness of this, that real collective social consciousness becomes impossible. Because your mind is already too separated by the emotions. That's what you see, of course, now. And that a lot of people think from their own group and their own social layers, those are good, and everything else is bad. And maybe there are some layers they want to grow to, but it's all on an emotional basis and not on a real clear sight basis, because polarity thinking, of course, doesn't belong to this reality. It is, of course, in this junky reality over here, but in reality you were once really incredible as a soul, but when you went with your soul into a body, then you became limited. So everybody should recognize that they are here as a limited person, with still some qualities, but also a lot of not qualities. And if you level them out, then you come out at zero. And that's why zero is the best point, because that's the point of reality where you really are. And collectively, is it of course so that when we would really work with each other, then all our plus points together makes it an interesting consciousness on this planet. But because we are in separation consciousness, in our body consciousness, in our junkie consciousness, emotional limited consciousness, we are living in a lower bardo at the moment. Makes sense. And at the same time, this system keeps you under this inferiority hypnosis, making you think you are an extraordinary person. So at night, when people are going to clean their teeth and they look at the mirror, they are still thinking they are something wonderful. Well, in most cases, if they would be honest and they would see through this system, they wouldn't. But they don't see through this system, so that's what they think, because it's a fake personality. So then you are always wonderful, of course. Because if you don't feel that way, whoa, then then you are nothing. Ooh, that's not good. Well, it's the best thing there is. But not emotionally, like, of course. Not when you are a junkie. Now, and what's the downside? The second downside, of course, it's keeping you a slave of those people who knows this system and manipulate you everywhere they want you to. Because if they know this system, they can manipulate you. What I already told you about your individual side with fear makes you active. So if some advertisement says, if you buy this jacket and then suddenly you are not a loser anymore, and you buy it, you buy that advertisement, you will buy this jacket, because it makes you active. So there are some laws that work also in this way, and you can misuse that, because the people are controlled by emotions and not by their consciousness anymore. But it even gets worse, of course, because most people will never see that what they call friendships or relationships sometimes are also only junkie connections. And why not? Because in most of the cases, of course, you are functioning in the same way. So you are honored that somebody is coming to you. So the dopamines and the endorphins are coming up into your system. Oh, it will be a nice evening. And because of that, your vision is limited and clouded to see what it really is. Yeah. So in this case, when we are talking about those kind of people, of course, emotions determinate if they will visit you. Yeah. And I call this self-pityness in a collective state. And will make them come by for compensation. That's why they come. Because they think dopamines and endorphins will make them happy again this evening. And if they're for their failed emotional functioning, because they are functioning as a junkie, they're not liberated from their emotions. They cannot look at it from their silent viewpoint, be not addicted to it. So, but of course you can get rid of those people also in an easy way. Because if you don't offer this, then you will not see them. Or invited by them. Or so called interested in you. Yeah, so if you finally grow in your consciousness and you see that there are a lot of people are only coming by because of their junkie emotions compensation need, then it's real simple. Don't offer it, and then they will leave. And what you of course notice with those people, and this is maybe also of course very recognizable in your own life, conversations must fit their emotional convictions. They are not open for other views. So sometimes you really want to learn people some things because you think that would really help them, but no, it must have fit their emotional convictions. So, and if you still try it, then you are a lunatic, or you are a conspiracy terrorist, or what else, whatever else. And because of the increase of the thought limitations created by the negative polarization of the emotional colored consciousness, every other thought will be emotionally rejected as fretful. That's the consequence of it. So most people who are controlled by their junky emotion hard drugs system, they don't want to have frets on it. So even if they know they function with a limited consciousness, and they don't want to change it, because if it is feeling good enough, then it's good. It's not about consciousness at all. Possible suggestions will be ignored. Only authority is accepted. So, and why is that, of course? Because they feel superb to you. Because they have a fake stability. A stability based on emotions. They are not in their centrum point. Of just with clear vision. And because most of the time they feel superior, what I just explained, or at least the same as you, or as failed as you. So accepting information from you is undermining, what I already told you, their fake emotional stabilized self-confidence. And that's of course really not nice to know, because sometimes you feel good for people, and you want to try to let them see some things, and then now, because of this, you understand that you talked air only for 20 years. Out of respect, they shut it up and let you talk because they thought, yeah, that's just something how you are. But they couldn't accept the information, they couldn't listen to that information because they felt superior. And you are not an authority person, so that's why they don't accept it. And that's also, of course, because of our growing up. I'm your parent, I know better. I'm your teacher, I know better. We are the government, we know better. So that's programmed in. And that can sometimes really be a hard thing to accept, that you say, oh wow. So that energy I put in for 20 years, that was all for nothing because I was talking to a junkie. Yeah. But I didn't recognize it because I was also feeling good because of the visitation. And but now you know. And of course we go from heavier to heavier. And with a lighter note on the end. And what you always maybe see is that some people may have experienced is that those kind of friendships means really nothing. It's all about self-interest first. It's separation consciousness. Body consciousness, controlled by emotions, is separation consciousness. It's I consciousness. If they can get better, then your 20 or 30 years friendship will be traded in for example, a cheap relationship. And of course that's real simple to explain, because a friendship mostly is on the high, on the middle emotional level. So you only offer endorphins and dopamines on the middle emotional level. And that cheap relationship offers dopamines on a high emotional level. So you are traded in. Because that person never looked at your friendship from an uncolored, unbiased based sense, and didn't recognize what the friendship was really worth. Because it was not about consciousness, a consciousness look at your friendship. It was all about emotions. It was all about a junkie who was visiting you. With, of course, also recognizable, that when the relationship ends, then they are back at your door. Then suddenly you are their friend again. So there are really also a lot of downsides, because a lot of people say, oh, emotions are so beautiful. Yeah, they are also. But this is also very important, because this is ruining the world at the moment. And nobody is talking about this. But I think also nobody is recognizing it, because from birth on, we were pressed in our body consciousness, and we think all those hard drugs emotions are normal in our life. And nowhere, and no one tells you that there is a silent point, a point of balance, and that you can function from that point of balance, and that you then not are subordinated to your emotions again anymore. So that doesn't mean you don't experience them, but you will experience them on a low emotional level. And then, of course, you are not addicted anymore to those emotions, so you can have a clear view, and because of that you don't have to fly high and fall low again anymore. And that keeps you strong enough so that the emotions can't rule your brain, your consciousness. Because I think consciousness is not a brain thing, but that's a different topic. And what you will also see when you have junky relationships is when they experience pleasure themselves, you are not invited. So those people come, of course, at your birthday, because then they can taste sugar, and then they can take alcohol. So then that's nice, of course, for their system of dopamines and endorphins. But other way around, you will not be invited, because their link with you is self-pityness in a collective state. They only come when their fake emotional system collapsed again, and call that friendship, or sometimes even a relationship. Yeah. But this is what a lot of people don't recognize. That's why I thought maybe it's interesting to make a video about this rather tough, confronting point, of course, because it is confronting. And we are going even more confronting, because in money situations you will be sold out cheaply, because money and junkies is a really strange thing. They know with billions behind the comma how much money you own them. But if you loaned them $30,000, mysteriously it was it disappeared in their consciousness. They don't know anything about it. But it is, of course, very logical if you see it from the lower body consciousness of the junkie emotion consciousness, because it's all eye separation consciousness. They only think about themselves. And of course, they lend that money, but still in a superiority feeling, and you are lesser than them, so why should they pay you back? That's not necessary, of course. You should be honored that you gave this emotional inferiority subordinated junkie your money. Recognizable, I think, again. And just simply ask to your friends. We walk on the street, $10,000 are laying in the gutter. I see it, I don't see it, but you see it. What will you do? And then most of the times that person will say, oh, then I will put it in my pocket. Yes, but I'm your friend, why shouldn't you share? Yeah, but you didn't see it. But if it is 500 billion, you see, yeah, then I also put it in my pocket. Yeah, but if you share it with me, 250 billion you can never make empty in your life. Why shouldn't you share? They don't. And then you see how strange that emotional subordinated consciousness is. it's really not nice. And of course, you see it also in the world, in the great world, that people do everything for money. And even worse, in wartime, that or lifetime situations, they will not blink an eye to trace you in if they can survive. And also this, I questioned on my work and in my friends with friends. From war is breaking out, the enemy is standing for you, and if you are a traitor and you trade me in, you can survive. What will you do? Oh, then I trade you in. Most of the people will say, without a problem, without a blink of an eye. And why is that? Because they are deeply in their body consciousness. And body consciousness is eye separation consciousness. But it's also a consciousness that that is still fearful for death. They are afraid to die. And because of that, they sold you out. No problem, they will sell you out. And of course people are wondering, what would you do? Yeah, I would try to look if I can take somebody's weapon and shoot as many people as I can before I go myself. That's what I should do in a situation like this. But yeah, I don't give a damn about being dead or alive, but I want to know for sure that when I come up that I didn't trade somebody in. So even it's an emotional junkie. That's how you should think. And yeah, again, it's body, lower consciousness, thinks in the first place for its own sake only. But on a lighter note, of course, in short, they only want to compensate emotionally and hear their own truths confirmed. And so sometimes you think that somebody is really interested in your wisdom, but it is because it's also their interest. And then still it's that they listen to you in the hope that their own truths are confirmed, because that gives them dopamine and endorphin. Nothing else. Everything else you talked about was air. Yeah, so most of the times you will see when you are on parties and everywhere, it's about nothing. It's only about ego. Oh wow, you are a doctor. Oh wow. So that's also only junkies, emotional dopamine, endorphin junkie parties. Yeah? So no personal growth is possible, not by your input. Totally absorbed in this compensation mode of their fake self-confidence, and even at the expense of you. If you are in balance and you are not subordinated to your emotions, then you know that you should leave a party when it is still nice, because then you have a nice memory. But if you are a junkie, then you want to stay at that party till the end, because you want to have a hard drugs experience. And that's what you also see a lot when people are going out, and then in the end of the evening, then oh, it must be even more. Let's take somebody unknown to my home. When I shower, it's all gone again, they think. So, yeah, and of course, when you are young, it's difficult to know this already. And it's more for the people who should know better that this information is there, of course. Yeah, because the older people should give a good example to this world. Because that's the way how it works. And finally we leave, and then we hope that the next generation will give the good examples to the world. But as you see nowadays, even a lot of old people are still subordinated to their emotions, because they never saw through this hard drugs law of compensation and balance things that was programmed in them from early age on. And nobody did tell him better. So if you then look to our world, what does this have for an effect? Then suddenly, yeah, you can see everybody in his own little community. It's all divided. So that makes it, of course, very difficult to build a happy place for everybody. But of course, there's a lot of native Indians also say it can only be good, can go well with you on the long term if it goes well with everybody. But yeah, this emotional addiction consciousness is in between nowadays. And because of the negative polarity separation consciousness, it's also even at the expense of all. You can see that we even live at the expense of this planet nowadays. So, it's no matter what. And, what I already explained also in the other videos a little bit, that commercially we are maximum impulsed on these lower body consciousness emotions for profit and self-interest. And I think this is one of the main problems why people have burnouts and why there is a lot of binge drinking and drugs use, because you think you are, even if you think if you are consciousness of it, then still your body is picking it up. All those advertisements and all those kind of things. So if you are constantly exposed in those kind of surroundings to those pictures and texts, then it will still have an effect on you. And now live in a world of big lies and full of corruption. That's also what we see. And it all has to do with this same junkie consciousness that we live in now. What is not recognized. And with secret agendas and telling you how beautiful everything is, of course. With a so-called law system that is also hollowed out nowadays, that punishes the poor and keeps them in check, because these are then more the effects you can see of it, how it's changed everything. And keeps the rich above the law and let us pay. And so there are a lot of lies that are created that makes us feel that we are responsible for it. And then of course there is a new tax law and then we have to pay for it. With laws that are so called good for us, all kinds of restrictions are placed on our freedom to grow and to express ourselves. Slowly we are going to a prison planet. And that's of course exactly the same as in nature. If you look at boss ape, then you see that boss ape makes very tight regulations to keep control over the crowd where he is boss ape for. And we are doing exactly the same. We are so-called higher expression beings, but we are still living in that animal consciousness. And of course the animal can do anything about it, because his surroundings and nature is tough, and he needs to express himself in this way. But for us human beings, it could be totally different, and it should be. So. And what of course another thing is that because of the separation consciousness, everything is divided in different parts, and every part becomes their own world and becomes complex, and that's why we also cannot change it, because we don't understand it. So how can we interfere? Make things unnecessarily complex, so the common people don't understand and they can't interfere anymore. Polarization. And also, of course, in the scientific community, they all developed their own languages. And how can they still talk to each other with all those different languages while they maybe are studying the same thing? Yeah. Now, yeah, of course, this was also one of those things. Those poor third world people, let's bring them work because we have work enough. Yeah? Cheap slave labor. So even when it is with the boat or through the airplane coming to your country, it's still one-tenth of the price that you have to make it in your country. But of course, what does it do? It breaks the prosperity and the economic stability of a country that keeps it strong. Yeah, privatization, that's also a nice word, of course, but to make things finally more expensive and with no control by the people, because it's not a government company anymore. Yeah, and of course, why is this happening? Because when you are a powerful person and you have the brain of an ape, then you want to have control over the population. That's what you see. Because junkie consciousness is separation consciousness. And there is also a deeper story behind it, but then you have to study the Sumerian clay tablets. Nou ja, in politics and all kinds of human prosperity organizations are also corrupted by the bones, because there is also most of the times a secret agenda behind, full with collaborators of our common people, so also traitors. Yeah. And of course what also happened is that all influential media channels are purchased. To spit out the lower body consciousness world, how to think, how to act, and which is in everything you see or hear, in movies, and think about it. If you look at some movies, then the murderer, of course, gets a nice laugh. How contradictional is it? And in television series, of course, that the mother is saying to the daughter, you must take him. Because he has already his own company. It's not about real love. No, that's not important. He has his own company. And of course, in music, it's also always also full of sex, and you need love and a relationship. And talk shows, of course, when they think maybe this thought form becomes a problem, then a talk show will address it, and then of course they will tell you how you should think about it. And of course we have a lot of emotions, so that clouds your clear perspective, so that you at the end of the evening are full of emotions and not with clear consciousness. And of course in sports there's also a lot of manipulation, because it's broad as we are the and it's but of course you see something else. It's also about separation consciousness. Oh, are you for that team? Then I don't talk to you because you are bad. Now, the news, of course, is also real simple. That they should say, yeah, we as behind our government there are big companies, and those big companies really want that gold mines and uranium mines. And but of course, we don't gonna tell you. So, yeah. There is a war between tribes over there, and la la la. So you don't also see the real thing. And there's always only the story they want you to know, but not what really happened. But even also in children cartoons. Oh, good, you have your makeup on again. Now you really belong to us. What is it doing to a little child of 7 years old? And most of the times the parents, their heads are also full, so they don't even listen to it, what the children are looking at. But this is all manipulation. And it is even worse, of course, because silent extermination of the world population is there. By war, diseases and starvation, and poverty, empty foods, GMOs, e-numbers, chemtrails, radiation, nuclear and magnetron microwave, vaccinations, medications, drugs, alcohol. And of course this is also that a lot of people can't believe that it is really this way, but junkie minds that are in their separation consciousness don't give a damn about you. And that's now the big problem on this planet, and that's why there is so much pollution in everything, also in all those kind of matters that we here address. And of course about radiation, if your microwave is 2.4 kilohertz and G4, the third band, is also 2.4 kilohertz, and You know what the microwave is doing to your food. What is it doing to you? You are also an electromagnetical spectrum. And what are all those electromagnetical interferences of antennas around you doing with you? And nuclear radiation is ionizing radiation is also not good. But the non-ionizing radiation is near ionizing radiation. We are really near to it. It's not that it is far away both frequencies anymore. Now, and of course you can take a look at all those kind of things, because war, diseases and starvation also has to do with the Sumerian clay tablet period. Because there was once one on a planet Earth who really didn't like the people, and that person was called Enlil. And so sometimes I call it also the thought forms are from Enlil are still raising around this planet. Yeah, and empty foods, of course, because of chemical enrichment of our. Of our soil, the natural elements, 84 elements and minerals are gone, so there is nothing in your food anymore. And, yeah, so we can go on, but I think one thing needs to be clear. Why is this here? It's because of our emotionally controlled inferior consciousness, and yeah, that's why I made this this video, because I think a lot of people are not knowing the effects of what those emotions do, because they came in very early in life, so we don't recognize them as abnormal, and we also never get taught about it. What are the downsides of those emotions? So very important, I think, that somebody sometimes tries to show what some of the downsides are, because it's of course just a part of the big picture, but I think you will have a picture now. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching this video, and I hope it cleared up a lot of things and maybe questions in your life. That you suddenly see, this is why, now I understand, yes. So, I wish everybody a very nice day or evening, and maybe till the next video.